Warning.
Foundation is meant to be a canvas for flawless skin. It's your base. People in old days would use puffs, and they would use the throwaway ones. This is to set your foundation with powder. I'm using a mineral veil. The eyes are very simple, and people in the old Hollywood days believed in opening your eyes, and they used very light shades. I'm going to start with a base, and this is a white base. Now for the liner, you want to do as light of color as your skin can allow. Most people would use like a light brown, only for darker skin would you really want to use black. I'm going to use a brown. And you want to get it as close to your eyeline as possible. Then what they would do is they would put a lighter color as your main base, and then a taupe on the top of your actual eyebrows. The top of your eyes. So I'm going to use a white color. Um, happier brush. This is a big trick of people like Marilyn Monroe. And then I'm going to use my taupe for the outer corner. Then for the outer corner, for the under the eyebrow, you can also use a lighter color. I think I'll use that same lighter one. Their eyebrows were something that they perfected back in those days. I'm not really that great with my eyebrows, so I will try my best. I don't really do a lot to them. What they advise is to tweeze them and use a brush, a lighter than your eyebrows color. I like to use this end to brush it up. In those days, they were very big about angling their brows. To really get a good healthy glow and brightness under your eyes, get a good night's sleep and drink plenty of water, ladies. But, you know, we always have things we can use to cheat Mother Nature, because not all of us get that, you know, 8 hours of sleep we're supposed to. This is something that they probably had different things in those days, but and I guess one fact that I didn't realize is that iron can actually cause under-eye dark circles, which unfortunately I was cursed with thalassemia, so yeah. Trades lead the trend of the way. Of course, we all know we have blemishes periodically, and you know, they say don't pick your any pimples, and you know, just allow your skin to go back to the way it was. But in the meantime, you know, we have to go out and looking our best, so you can use a concealer in little spots that you might find. This is what they would do back in the days. Nowadays, we do a lot of different things when we do You know, we have heavier concealers, of course, but I wanted to do a tutorial on how they would do it. And they concealed after. Oh, of course I forgot mascara. That's one of the most important parts. These days we have this. We have our little eyelash curlers, which they might have had something similar, but they did have mascara. Just different formula. They knew about curling their lashes. I actually believed in doing this as well. And I will link a video to the tutorial that I wanted to show you while I was doing this. Unfortunately, our computer is not doing well with the volume, so you'll have to bear in mind, or you'll have to bear with me, sorry. We're hopefully gonna get speakers.
It has to be louder.
Cause I was going to have a great setup for you while I was playing the video, actually do what they were saying, but it didn't work out. But this lady knew it. She knew beauty. I believe it was for the 60s, but I'm not sure. Oh, this is another thing I do with my brows. I love doing this. This is from Elizabeth Arden. Now we get to the nitty gritty. Blush and our lips, the last two to perfection. And this is, I used a lighter blush than what I'm normally used to because females in those days, in the good old days, old-fashioned times, they were very much more about being refined and not as, like, you know, overly elaborate that we've gotten these days, and I wanted to kind of bring out just a simple, natural elegance of the, I guess, 50s or 60s. But this woman says, don't go any closer to your nose when you do your blush than a pencil, I believe is what she said. I'm not 100% accurate on that. But you go way up here, you start up here, and you bring it up to your hairline. That's how they did it. Which is interesting. Everybody has, you know, their own theories. also said you can contour with blush. I think I'll use this for. Basically, or any darker shade. I think it's kind of neat. Never thought of it like that, you know? With your blush. And I guess contouring your chin line makes it appear thinner. Which don't we all like, ladies? To perfection and beauty is the lips. And I'm doing it old fashioned today, like all this stuff. But I am going to use a lip liner because I just gotten so accustomed to it, you know. Some of them probably did have something like a lip liner, but this is a kind of natural shade by Charlotte Tilbury. Balance yourself. You get a good amount on your lips. And she says use a neutral or very light pale color for your lips. Gloss. It's got pheromones in it. I love pheromones. Enjoyed this back in time to history type beautification tutorial, and always remember, elegance is within you, so bring it out and shine. Bye. Until next time.